Hello viewers, welcome to our second lesson in the series on continuity and differentiability. In our first lesson, we talked about the continuous functions. Today, we will discuss differentiability of a function. You were introduced to the concept of derivatives in grade 11. Do you remember how we define derivative of a function at a particular point? Let's refresh your memory. The definition says that if f is a real function and c is a point in its domain, then the derivative of f at c is defined to be the limit of the quotient fx minus f of c and x minus c, if this limit exists. Now, the whole discussion of today is on this condition, this limit exists. The limit may not exist. When does the limit exist? When do we say that f dash c is defined? You remember very well that the limit of any function as x approaches c depends on two quantities called as the left hand limit and the right hand limit. So, this limit, that is limit of fx minus f of c upon x minus c, again depends whether as x tends to c from its lesser or greater side converge to the same value or not. And that is what brings up the definition of left hand and right hand derivatives. What is left hand and right hand derivative? Left hand derivative is defined as limit of f of x minus f of c upon x minus c as x takes values lesser than c but very close to c. It should be limit of f x minus f of c by x minus c as x takes values closer to c but greater than c, indicated as c positive. And we say that a function is differentiable at x is equal to c if these two limits, that is the left and the right hand derivative, are finite and equal. That is what the concept of differentiability of a function at a particular point requires. So, we will now take few problems where we will examine these limits and discuss whether the function is differentiable at a particular point or not. A function f is said to be differentiable in an interval ab if it is differentiable at every point of ab. So, once we know how to examine the differentiability at a point, we also have an understanding of what it means by a function differentiable over a certain interval. There are few other results which will help us as we go further down in our lesson. And the very first theorem says, if a function f is differentiable at a point c, then f is also continuous at that point. A very significant result, and the proof is not too difficult. I'll suggest that you do try the proof. Today we will only concentrate on the problems. We also have a result coming as a corollary which says that every differentiable function is continuous. What about the converse? The converse is not true. One of the examples that you can easily see as we go further with testing the derivability at a point will be of the modulus function. You know that it's a V-shaped graph, remember? So, it's continuous. And subsequent part of the lesson will teach you that it is not differentiable at x is equal to 0. So, remember these results and refer to them as and where the need arises. Let's take a problem to discuss the differentiability of a function at a particular point. The problem states, examine the differentiability of the following function fx at x is equal to 2, and how is the function defined? For x less than 2, it takes a value x minus 1. For x greater than or equal to 2, it takes the value 2x minus 3. Before we get down to finding the left and the right hand derivative, let's take a look at its graph. This is the graph of the function that was just defined. Examine and see that it has two paths. For x greater than 2 and less than 2, the definition is changing. There is no gap in the graph, so it's a very much a continuous function. But do you notice that at x is equal to 2, there is a sharp corner being formed? Any function which has a sharp corner in its curve is not differentiable at that point. Why? Because you cannot define a tangent at those points. And therefore, the concept of differentiability, which was related to the understanding of the tangent slope, suggests that if a curve has a sharp corner, or of course, if it's breaking, the function will not be differentiable at these points. But this is not enough, and you cannot plot graph of each of these functions. So, let's get down to finding the left and the right hand derivative. The left hand and the right hand derivative come from the definition given earlier. Right hand derivative is limit of fx minus f of c upon x minus c as x takes values greater than c. That gets replaced at x equal to 2 by fx minus f of 2 by x minus 2 as x approaches 2 from its greater side. The definition of the function suggests that fx is 2x minus 3 when x is greater than 2. So, replace fx by 2x minus 3. Simplify and also note that f of 2, that is the value of the function, is coming again by the same relation because 2 was included in this branch. F of 2 turns out to be 1. This simplifies to be nothing but limit of just the constant 2 and therefore 2. So, right hand derivative is 2. What about the left hand derivative? Again, it's limit of fx minus f of c by x minus c as x takes values less than c but close to c. At 2, again fx less than 2 takes the value x minus 1, f of 2 remains the same 1. That is nothing but all just simply 1. So, what do you observe? Left hand limit, that is the left hand derivative, is not equal to right hand derivative at x equal to 2. So, what do we say? F is not differentiable at x is equal to 2. Let's take another problem. A little more elaborate. It says for what values of a and b is this function derivable at x is equal to 1. Here we need two unknown values, that is the value of a and b. But we have a condition only about derivability. I think you have all gone through the process where you have understood that to find two unknowns, we must know at least two conditions. So, what is the second thing you know about this function? A function will be derivable at x is equal to 1 if it is continuous at x is equal to 1. So, that's an unsaid condition in the question which you need to start with. Let's begin and see what we get as we look at continuity at x is equal to 1. Left hand limit is limit of fx as x takes values less than 1, which is same as limit of x square by the definition, and therefore, the left hand limit is simply 1. The right hand limit is limit of fx as x takes values greater than 1, replacing fx with 2ax plus b, we get 2a plus b, and therefore, the left hand limit equal to right hand limit will ensure that the function is continuous at x is equal to 1. So, the left hand limit is 1, right hand limit is 2a plus b. What about f of 1? The value of the function is 1 square, which is simply 1. So the function will be continuous at x is equal to 1 if the left hand limit equals right hand limit equals the value of the function. That gives rise to the condition 2a plus b equal to 1. Hold on to that and let's begin the conditions on derivability. F is derivable at x is equal to 1 if the left hand derivative equals right hand derivative. The left hand derivative by a definition is limit fx minus f of c by x minus c as x takes values closer to c less than c. What do I get here then? At 1, we replace fx by its value when x is less than 1. At 1, it takes the value 1. So, the limit becomes limit of x square minus 1 by x minus 1, which is nothing but limit of x plus 1. As x approaches 1, that is same as 2. So, the left hand derivative at x equal to 1 takes the value 2. What about the right hand derivative? Right hand derivative again can be processed in the same manner, making sure that when you replace fx, you follow the definition which said that fx is 2ax plus b when x is greater than 1. Now, we need to figure out how to find this limit, and that is where we use the idea that 2a plus b is equal to 1, and therefore, the limit simplifies to be just the limit of 2a, and that is nothing but just the constant 2a. So, we have the left hand derivative as 2, right hand derivative as 2a. Therefore, the function will be derivable at x is equal to 1 if 2a is equal to 2, that is a is equal to 1. Once I have the value of a, we are surely close to finding the value of b, since 2 of a plus b is equal to 1. Doesn't that give you b equal to minus 1? And that's exactly what the question asks for. The function will be derivable at x is equal to 1 if a is 2 and b is minus 1. I hope with these questions you become more confident of discussing the differentiability of a function at a given point. Don't forget that both the concept of continuous functions and differentiable functions depend heavily on the concept of limits. So, do brush up some of the basic techniques of evaluation of limits, and then nothing can stop you from attempting any of these questions on your own with confidence. See you in our next lesson next time. Thank you.